this is Jamie Humphries with another Guitar Interactive review, and we are taking a look at the Gibson Les Paul Zakk Wylde signature model. Now, this is based on Zakk's original guitar that he started playing, was famously seen playing when he joined Ozzy's band way back in 1987, 1988. And if my memory serves me correctly, the guitar, his original guitar, he wanted something done a little bit unusual with it, because he obviously was playing a cream Les Paul, which was associated with Randy Rhoads. And there was a few similarities between himself and Randy Rhoads in appearance, long blonde hair, bell-bottom jeans. And so he wanted to have the, almost like the Vertigo logo, spiral from the Alfred Hitchcock movie. And apparently, or so I recall, the guitar came back with this design on it, of these concentric circles as opposed to the other design. Construction, it's a carved top, mahogany body, and the interesting thing about this guitar is that it features on the back, if I turn it over, it features a three-piece unfinished maple neck. So you've got a mahogany body with a maple neck on it. As you can see, we've got the Zakk Wylde logo there, him with his bell bottoms and his circled Les Paul there. We've got the traditional bell-shaped Gibson machine heads. Turning the guitar back over, we've got the normal Gibson-style bridge. And moving on to the pickups, this guitar features active pickups. These are EMG 85s and 81s, which Zakk has used predominantly throughout his career. Okay, turning the guitar back over, let's take a look at the fingerboard. We have an ebony fingerboard with the block abalone inlays on there. Moving down to the controls of the guitar, two volume controls, two tone controls. Obviously these controls are working on the bridge pickup, and these two controls are working on the neck pickup. Bridge, both pickups together, and the neck pickup. So, again, if you're familiar with the Les Paul, there's going to be no surprises here to you, apart from when it comes to the sound. It is quite a weighty guitar, I'm going to say that. You know, in terms of playing it on a gig, you can maybe see why Zakk is the way he is. maybe it's from playing this guitar for so many years. It's a pretty weighty beast. But then obviously that adds, it's a great big lump of wood, and that's obviously going to add a lot to the sound of the instrument. So I've got it running into a JCM 800 Marshall amplifier, which we're going to be taking a look at in another review in this issue of Guitar Interactive. And also, just to crunch things up a little bit more, I've got a Zakk Wylde MXR overdrive on the floor, also sporting the same graphic there, which we should also be looking at when we review all of Zakk's signature pedals within this same issue. Let's have a listen to the bridge pickup to start off with. You can hear by backing the volume down, the amp does, the guitar does clean up quite nicely. If I push the volume up, we start to drive the amp a bit more. We start to, you know, really hear the benefits of using the EMG active pickup. If I kick in the overdrive pedal now, we start to get really nice searing lead tones, and also slightly heavier tones, and some of those signature natural harmonics, pinched harmonics, will start to really jump out. So you can hear, you know, really the guitar really starts to come alive. Obviously we start to chuck a little bit more gain, and some of the tones that you'd associate more with Zakk Wylde start to creep out the instrument. Okay, now we're going to flick the pickup selector into the middle position, and that's the two pickups together. And I've got the volume back down a little bit. if I start to hit the guitar a bit harder, it starts to break up. Again, any minute sort of adjustment to the volume controls will really change the sound of the output of the pickups and ultimately how it's reacting with the amplifier. So there's a myriad of different tones available from this guitar. Onto the neck pickup. Back off the tone a little bit, we can almost get into some of those old vintage Clapton sort of territory. Okay, so if we now kick in the overdrive, we can have a listen to how that sounds with the tone rolled off onto the neck pickup. That's one of the things I do like about using a Les Paul, is the fact that you can have such massive differences going between. With all the tone rolled off, and then down to the bridge pickup with all the tone up. So you can go from very, creamy lead tones. So you can really hear how I can go from very creamy, thick, warm tones to those really biting sort of metal sounds out of the guitar. Lots of pinched harmonics. So there you go. To my mind, this is a great rock guitar. Obviously, one of the biggest factors is going to be, or one of the two biggest factors in when purchasing a guitar like this is you've got to be a Zakk Wylde fan. Is the graphic really for you? Do you want to be sporting that on the guitar? Also, the other thing, it's a very, very weighty guitar, but then, with that weight comes that tone. It is a very stylistic guitar in terms of the sounds that you can get with the pickups, but then we've just demonstrated that with a little bit of adjustment and working with the tone control and backing the volumes down, you can get some pretty decent and authentic old bluesy tones out of it. So, all in all, obviously a high-priced guitar. It's at the higher end of the market. So at that price, you would expect a fair amount of high features. The guitar comes with a deluxe case as well, a deluxe hard case. But more importantly, it's what the guitar sounds like for me, this definitely gets my thumbs up. So. There you have it. So hope you enjoyed this short demonstration and review of the guitar of the Zakk Wylde custom Gibson Les Paul. And see you again soon for some more reviews.
So when we do tours now, it's like seeing our extended family,
Yeah.
So, that's what Black Label's just become, this gigantic family. So, no, we're definitely looking forward to it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.